Today, we will answer an algebra challenge given by one of our followers. And the question goes like this. What is the remainder when this number 1 raised to the power of 2013 plus 2 raised to the power of 2013 plus all the way down to 2012 raised to the power of 2013 plus 2013 raised to the power of 2013 is divided by 2014? Now, pause this video right now and see if you can answer this question, because I will show you the answer and the solution in 3, 2, 1. By the way, the answer to this question is 1007. Now, the question is, how do we get 1007? And here's the solution. Alright, for this question, we will use the concept of modular arithmetic. So we can rewrite this question as follows. X is congruent to this number 1 raised to the power of 2013 plus 2 raised to the power of 2013 all the way down to 2013 raised to 2013 mod 2014. What we're going to do is to get the remainder when this number is divided by 2014. Now, of course, we will use some properties of modular arithmetic. Now, one observation in this question is their exponent. The exponent is 2013, and 2013 is an odd number. Now, aside to the exponent 2013, here are some observations in this question. First, 2013 raised to 2013, we can rewrite this as 2014 minus 1 raised to 2013. Now, 2014 mod 2014, this is a multiple of 2014, so this is just 0 mod 2014. What's left is negative 1 raised to 2013. Now, since 2013 is an odd number, and when a negative number raised to an odd power, the result is a negative number. So, the result is negative 1 raised to the power of 2013 mod 2014. Similarly, 2012, we can rewrite this as 2014 minus 2. Again, 2014 mod 2014, this is just 0 mod 2014. So what's left is negative 2 raised to the power of 2013 mod 2014, and so on and so forth. Now, we will use this concept to answer this question. And using this, we can rewrite our equation as x is congruent to 1 raised to the power of 2013 plus 2 raised to the power of 2013 all the way. Now, we have negative 2 raised to 2013. This is just 2012 raised to 2013. And negative 1 raised to 2013. This is just 2013 raised to 2013. Now, on the middle, we have 1006 raised to 2013 plus the middle term, 1007 raised to 2013 minus 1006 raised to 2013. As you can see, this is just 0. 2 raised to the power of 2013 and negative 2 raised to 2013, this is just 0. Positive 1006 raised to 2013 and negative 1006 raised to 2013, this is just 0. So what's left is 1007 raised to the power of 2013 mod 2014. Now, let's focus on this result. So, this is just 1007 raised to 2013 mod 2014. And now, from here, take note that 2014 is 2 times 1007. Although we know 1007 is 19 times 53, we don't care because 2 times 1007 is enough. Now, let's rewrite this congruence into two different congruence as x is congruent to 1007 raised to the power of 2013 mod 1007, and the other one is 1007 raised to 2013 mod 2. Now, solving this, the first one, since 1007 is a multiple, of course, of 1007, so this is just 0 mod 1007, this is for sure, or simply we can say that x is a multiple of 1007, or 1007 times k, wherein k is a positive integer. Now, on the other hand, x is congruent to 1007 raised to 2013 mod 2. We know 1007, we can rewrite this as 1006 plus 1. Now, 1006 is an even number, so this is just 0 mod 2. So what's left is 1 raised to the power of 2013. And 1 raised to the power of 2013 is just 1. So we can say that x is congruent to 1 mod 2. Now, using these two results, what we're going to do is to find the smallest x that satisfies this condition. So this is x is a multiple of 1007 and x is 1 mod 2. Therefore, the following numbers are multiple of 1007. We have 1007, 2014, 3021. And the smallest number that is a multiple of 1007 and 1 mod 2 is this 1007. Therefore, we can say that x is equal to 1007. Or simply, this is the remainder when 1 raised to the power of 2013 plus 2 raised to the power of 2013 all the way down to 2013 raised to 2013 is divided by 2014. And that is our answer to this question. Therefore, what is the remainder when this number is divided by 2014 and our answer is 1007. And before we end this video, let's have an extra challenge. So your goal is to find the remainder when this number is divided by 2026. And as always, we are done.